sure. Last time I might have done this and leaked a spoiler, so. I'm not gonna tell you. We're not gonna talk about it. But we're gonna talk about a lot of other stuff, because let's make some noise. With Sean Gunn, everybody. How cool is it though, doing what you do now that you can, now you can see an audience that you affect? Like, you're an actor, you're behind the camera, in front of the camera, you don't really see the people you reach every day, but now you come to these shows, and like, look at this. This has gotta be pretty cool, right?
Yeah, it is, it's really, really cool. It's overwhelming
sometimes?
Well, it is sometimes, and particularly now, I've been doing cons now for like 3.5 years, and it's pretty great. It's like a really interesting way to get to know fans and to hear, to really interact with how people are perceiving the work that we do. And I love hearing from you guys and hearing what you think and hearing all your gripes and complaints but more than that, just seeing what you really thought and to meet the fans who are really interested in what we do. I love it.
How did you come to be involved with Guardians of the Galaxy? I know you had a guy on the inside. You knew a guy.
Yeah, I knew a guy. and I had been acting professionally, for over 20 years now. And so when Guardians came around, I'd already done Gilmore Girls. I was I'd been acting for a while. My brother had been on his own course, and we always worked together when we could. But we also, our careers went in a different path at times. And so then when he was hired to do Guardians, and he knew it was such this massive job that, he went from directing a $4 million movie to a, $180 million movie or whatever it was. I don't know, whatever it was. Whatever the official word was, I swear that's how it was. And so he has this massive job, and he wants people that he's worked with and trusted, and so he brought me in to do a couple of different things on that first movie, and I was really happy to be there and happy to be there to support him and to do whatever I could to make that movie as good as it could possibly be, because I knew he was the right guy for the job. And then that's just escalated, and now I'm, several movies in, and I'm up there, and Marvel did their 10-year photo for GQ and with all the people, and they invited me to be there, and I really felt like part of the family, and it's been a hell of a trip.
It's amazing, man. That's very cool. And we were talking about this a little earlier. Of course, not only you play Craig, but you also are a Rock as well.
Yes.
And for the Guardians cast, they got used to seeing you as Rocket, and squatting down or kneeling down. But when you went over to do Infinity War, was there any surprise looks you got? I know you did stuff with Hemsworth. How did he take it?
Yeah, it was always interesting to work with an actor for the first time because I look pretty freakish when I'm playing. When I'm playing Rocket, I'm very limber, and I actually get down, and my job for each take, as I see it, is to get my eyes to where Rocket's eyes are. So I spend a lot of time on the ground, and I spend a lot of time squatting, and a lot of time moving in the squat position. So when other actors haven't seen it before, the Guardians are used to it. So, Chris and Zoe and Dave, they're like, oh, that's Sean. We've worked with him a ton, but working with Chris Hemsworth for the first time and having him be like, wow, you really do that. You really get down to do it, was cool. And then he was great when I would work with new people. Chris would be like, oh yeah, no, you gotta see how this guy works. It's really weird. But it was cool. Yeah, people flip out on it a little bit the first time they see it.
No That was fascinating too. We're talking about the scene, I know it's not too much of a spoiler if you haven't seen it yet, but there's a scene with you know, Winter Soldier and Rocket, and and he's spinning you around, and you're actually still in that scene.
Yeah, we shot that. You know, and it's like I said, I'm always looking to get my eyes to where Rocket's eyes are. So that reference take, now you gotta understand, like, yeah, we shot that, but it's, you know, when you're shooting with CGI, there's so many different ways that you have to shoot something. So even when I'm in a take, I'm usually only in there for one or two good shots as reference, and then I step behind the camera and do the lines, you know, from just behind the camera for the other actors, but they're looking then at something that's blank. But they've already had the reference, so they know where the actor is and they know where the eyes are and things like that. And so for a take like that, I'm sure he had, you know, many different ways that he had to shoot that take. But one of them was for Rocket's face and what Rocket's doing. And in that take, that's just me spinning right along with him. And I don't, you know, I was, you know, I'm tall enough that I could just also be standing. So I'm sure that's pretty funny looking. But yeah, that's Sebastian with his hand out and me out there in front of him. Spinning around, you know. But it's definitely strange. But yeah, we shoot pretty much every single thing that Rocket does. We shoot in case we need it. You know, some of it we don't use, the visual effects team doesn't use, but a lot of it they do. And so it's, so yeah, we shoot all of it.
Yeah, and of course, also, you know, you're